All right, I'm back. I did update the channel and all that. Hanging out in this Destroyer Nation. As I do from time to time. Okay. Gonna try and turn that off. Gonna keep going on this, I guess. Gotta do it. Gotta do it. I did pull an image here of our first book cover. First book for rewrite will be The Last Wish by Andrei Sapkowski. The first book of the Witcher series. Jeez. That looks weird. I mean, I thought this was only. Oh, and you know what? No, you're right. This is much larger than I thought it was. That's fine. It's the right aspect ratio, I'm pretty sure. Which is the important part. I did it wrong. Give me a sec. Oops. History. Seems way too big for, like, that doesn't seem like an actual 100%, but, you know, whatevs. What do I know? Oh, is it not the right aspect ratio? Oh no. I may have messed up. No, that's fine. That's fine. And the reason that's fine is because so top corner 130, perfect. Yeah, that's totally fine because it'll work out to have a little bit extra spacing, and that's fine. I'm okay with that. No problem. Do wish it was black though. Though I think I'm using the black a little too much. I think I need to up my color schemes a little bit. For example, that border, maybe that border should be that green that we were using. The one that we were using over here. this color. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe that's the wrong thing. It looked brighter over here. Am I wrong? I think that's because it's on the black. Yeah. It looked too dark. Bright color though. Because if I swap this, hit X to swap. No, it doesn't. It's the right color. Actually, see without the effect. Is it the same color without the effect? Sorry, I'm just mumbling to myself. It's all good. Been working on this a while. 0 0 FF 0 0. Yep, same color. It just looks darker. Not as vibrant. If I were to, I'm gonna duplicate this just to test something out. I'm gonna hide that one and I'm gonna rasterize it. Then we're gonna go FX, outer glow. Doesn't do the same thing that I want it to do, which is weird. Huh. Odd. Maybe that's just me. It's wait, I should save this as so, you know, if Photoshop crashed, I wouldn't lose everything that I've been working on. It's a good call. Let's quick export this. Oh, take it back. It's very bright. It's so bright. I also think these internal borders should not be this thick. The other thing I'm noticing is that as cool as it is to have that image, that book image, fit perfectly there, I actually think there should be a border around it as well. Now that I'm looking at it. Okay. Well, I'm gonna delete that for now because I don't need it. And I think that's too bright. Oh, you know what I should do is instead of this having this layer be black, this layer should be like a dark gray. Like a slate gray or something like that. That would make more sense, I think, in the grander scheme. Like almost like this Adobe color gray. I wonder. This would be really funny, but I wonder if. Can I select this as a color? Oh, I can. Hilarious. See, that makes more sense. But I'm thinking, yeah, so I want that to be 500 pixels. So I did 500 by 375. How much border is that around it? Yeah, what was the final size of this image? Not that one. Three. So 375. My pen not working? 375 minus 333. 42 pixels, preferably split evenly. These borders would be better as like 50%. But mean, I'd have to put an additional 25 pixels somewhere. Yeah. Just thinking out. So this would be chat. That's a 50 pixel bar. Twelve eight, right? 1280? Yeah, it should be 1280. Would it not be 1280? No, it'd be 1180. minus 100. It's entirely possible that that's just too much, too big of a screen. Me try something. Horizontal split. So that horizontal split probably doesn't work for me anyway. It's a little bit bigger. So not 1920, but what's a little bit bigger than that? Sixteen nine? 69 might be okay. Yeah, 69 I like. Okay, yeah. I'm gonna have to make a few changes here to some stuff. So this will be background gray. Book split, book cover. That's not going to be good enough, but yeah, I'll come back to that in a second. Delete that small one. 69 works for me. Vertical split's fine. That border I'm probably gonna delete. Okay. This one, call this one border. So I know this seems like a step backwards, but it actually makes a lot of sense because what I'm noticing is that actually I'm gonna delete the horizontal and vertical split because I'm gonna have to probably change that, and I'm gonna delete that one too. I'll leave that for now. So what I'm noticing is that that's 720, 720, 169. Okay, cool. What I'm noticing is that I want to have names for one. I need to have the host names in here. So I want more with that for sure. So that's definitely a thing I want. Other thing I want is if I go to my properties here, that's your stroke. That's what I want. Five pixel outer stroke. Five, maybe 10. Then, if I go to my transform here and go to the bottom corner, I want my X to be 125. Sense that makes sense to me. Quick export this. I mean, that color combo looks atrocious, but that's okay. I'm just trying to get sort of basic sort of shapes down first, and then I'll get that stuff. I want that to be an outer stroke. Maybe it should be an inner stroke. Half and half. Maybe that's the way it should go. Basic shapes. I know, right? Do the same thing with this guy. Have a white stroke. 10 pixels. Inner. 10 pixels. Cool. Eventually, before I export this, I'm gonna take out those colors. Because they'll look awful. And you won't be able to cover them. But you want to leave like your borders here so that they work, so that you have them in the overlay. Like eventually I'll just go like this and that'll just be a black. Well, I'll have to cut out the shape too, actually. Like when I'll go into this background grid, I'll make a clipping mask and I'll cut out all the stuff that needs to be empty so that I can throw other things in there afterwards. So, your main host here, again, 10 pixels, white. Oh, whoops. Yeah, I don't want that one. This one. This is the one. Yes. Important to stretch. Yeah, I prefer the way this is now. As much as I like them when they were kind of touching, what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to go like this, and I'm going to take that. Can I paste it? No. And I copy this. No, maybe. Ah, there we go. Got it. I'm gonna make it smaller, but that works. Oops. Uh, 300 pixels? No, let's do 150. Now we're starting to get there. File. I know I keep exporting this, but it looks funny on this screen, and I just want to see it, how it looks. I don't know why it looks so weird. I think I hit something that caused it to, I think I hit a hotkey that like muted the colors in a way. Because when I look at it here, like these are very bright. Even, you know what I mean? What hotkey did I hit? Is there a thing? Oh, that's not what I wanted. Control F is find, not level filter. Weird. Oh. There we go. That's what did it. That proof colors option totally messed me up. So now So I need a border here where I can put like a put the border and then build our chat box and then have this. Don't do that. So what do I want? These are 10 pixel borders. Yeah. Okay. It's 500, 375. Let's put 10 pixels on each side. So we'd say actually, no, let's just do exactly what I was doing. If I do this like this, do it as an outer. Then, when I go to grab this image, it should mostly fit. No, it needs to be bigger. I think I should do it as like 550 maybe. That makes sense. I think 550. That look good? That looks good. I like that. That's fine. I feel like there is a bunch of wasted space though, which is unfortunate. But you know, that's not always a bad thing. I mean, it kind of sounds like a bad thing. I'm also not an expert in design by any means. It is what it is. See, that looks really cool. Then if we move that underneath here. Oh. Oh yeah, I gotta adjust because I messed with the aspect ratio with these guys because of the way I did them. They're actually not exactly the way they were. They're also a little bit off, aren't they? They're not quite as low as they should be. Go this one. Thirteen, 25, I think. Yeah, that looks right to me. Not quite. Maybe I'm still five off. One, two. cool. Yeah, I'm really starting to like the way this looks. I could totally make this slate gray background in OBS though. Can't, couldn't I? Like, if I just did, yeah, if I just exported like an image of just the background. So let's go. Show hide all other layers and then file export, quick export. Oh, yeah, well, I didn't put it in the right spot, that's why. It's like, did this not go to the right spot? Yeah, so there's that like slate gray. And then I hide that. Then export, quick export. Main temp, then, oh, actually, should hide this as well. Sorry, I realize you guys can't see, but I'm getting there. Boom. Yeah, see, that works perfectly. Just waiting for it to show up in the video preview. I got like a 20-second delay. It's pretty crazy. And then, yeah, obviously, these colors are going to not be there. They will be empty squares so that you can put cameras in them and like stuff, other stuff. But yeah, I like the way that looks. Very basic, but you know, we're not going for some anything super crazy at the moment. And like I said, like I'm not a graphic designer. We have an actual graphic designer. He's going to be doing real stuff. Oh, actually, there is one other thing. Well, no, I'll test that after. So we need to make another square. I kind of like these white borders I got going on. They're nice. color. There we go. I gotta resize this rectangle too. Oops. -260 -200, so it should actually be, should actually be 1960, right? Oh, yeah. Let's adjust that actually. Because I did, because I made the strokes internal, they actually don't fit quite right pixel wise. So let's make a quick adjustment here. I'll just do them outside. So it's 10 pixels outside of the 720. So this should be, let's go transform. Position, right. I was like, what the hell was I doing? So the X position should be 110, right? That makes sense. No, apparently not. Apparently, I'm wrong. Not gonna lie, I'm not sure I 100% understand how stroke pixels work. So, you know, is what it is, I guess. Let's try some stuff. And it's not 110. Is it 105? No. 100. Right, because the stroke is still part of what you're doing, right? That makes sense. So then, so that's 110. 110. Let's go with this guy. To go up more. I don't know about any of this. Yeah. I hang out with a lot of visual artists, like a lot of them. And that's the only reason I know anything about any of this, to be honest. It's because I do. Why does that look off to me? I need to change this background color. Oh, yeah, instead of doing it like that, what I should do. I should just make this a color overlay. So then I can just select the color rather than doing all this weird. changey stuff of having to like paint bucket it all the time. Just looking for a bright color. So that I can see. Problem is my stroke color is white, and that doesn't help. So 1280, 720, 10 pixel stroke, outside edge. Makes no sense why you would be 31. And also makes no sense why you would be this. Essentially, I just want to make it so that the strokes are on top of each other, is the gist of what I was trying to do there. And then this guy, main host, 10 pixels, outer edge. Your Y should be 100. Oh, yeah. No, that makes sense. That works for me. Okay, cool. So now. Now we gotta resize our rectangles here. Rectangle 2, this is a book description, is what this will be. It'll just be like the title and author sort of thing. And maybe if it's from a series, maybe the part of the series it is. But then, okay. So. 10 pixels outer edge. Good, good. Change that. Okay. Now, your height and width make no sense. So. We are going to hide that, and then we're going to do this. Add edge 10 pixels. So if I'm not mistaken, and I very well could be, actually there's an easy way to find this out. I go bottom corner. What's our y-axis at? 2060. And our x-axis is at 2690. But this actually makes perfect sense because what we're going to do. We're going to do rectangle one here. We're gonna hit transform. We're gonna say bottom corner. And our y, x is vertical, y is horizontal, so 3840 minus 100, so it should be 3740, I think. No, that's wrong. What am I, crazy? No, this should be 3740. I might have to make adjustments for the pixels, but that's fine. And then our Y is going to be 2060. Cool. I think that's correct. That looks correct, right? Yeah, that looks correct. We just need to resize it so that it actually makes sense. So 2160 minus 200 would be 1960. What do you say our y was 100? No, that's wrong. Then it's too tall. 1960 is too tall. 2160. No, it'd be 240, right? So it'd be 1920. Way too big. Not 2090, 2060. No. What the hell? Is that not accurate? Is that not what I was trying to do? So why is my math keep being wrong? About 2050. Does that make sense? That might make sense. Why doesn't that work the way it should? Why do I feel crazy? Might be 1940 because it'd be 10 on each side, right? Oh man. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Yeah, so I was correct in the first place. It's plus 10. So then width wise, it should be probably 10 pixels less, I would say. Hopefully this one won't be as annoying to do. Oh, it always does it from that side. God damn it. At least this one. Bottom left should be 38, 40, so 37, 40. Boom. Oh, yeah, well, that should not be a 5 pixels. That should be this. It's like, why is this 5 pixels off? Well, now we know. Boom. Okay, good. So that's our chat box. Now we can put these back in and start to align them and get them right. So we're going to take our book description and move it down here for a sec. Perfect. Gotta resize this. It's the wrong size. Height should be 550. And width should be 550 for the book cover? Yeah, 550 by 375. So if they have the same height, they should fit the same, right? Does that not make sense? Am I crazy? Let me just make sure that this is sitting in the right spot. Yeah, it's not. It's 3 pixels off. That's why. That makes more sense. And this is probably sitting somewhere funny too. They're still weird, different sizes though, which makes no sense. Oh, it's because I didn't fix the stroke. That's why. There we go. That's why. There we go. That works. Now I just need to figure out how wide it needs to be. So if we go to our chat box is 1040. Ten forty minus 375 minus 10. Calculator. 40 minus 375 minus 10. 655 should be the right number. Cool. Then we just gotta go top corner. This should be 3740 by 100. Perfect. There we go. Look at that. She's a beaut. That's awesome. Okay, cool.
So now I think the last thing I need to do, man, it's already 4 o'clock. I think the last thing I need to do, and then I'm gonna call the stream, I think, is that I need to put in a it really does feel like there's a bunch of wasted space here. I wonder if there's a way I could fix that. Well, the things I gotta add I gotta add. Sorry, totally distracted. I gotta add names, like boxes for the names, and that should be it. So yeah. Once I have boxes for the names, I think I'm done. That should be everything. I'll put that up top above the border. That can pop in. That's fine. Oh. The one thing I do think is that what I need to do is I need to align the, yeah, I need to align the slash with that edge. Because it looks less weird that way. So let's take out some of these gradients, some of these midsections as well. And see what it looks like. This one I'm actually gonna leave as black, I think. It's gonna be black with probably white or green lettering. I don't know if I'm gonna have the glow on the name. Probably a similar lettering style to what goes here. Actually, we can do a quick test of that if we want. I'm gonna have to take this way down though. It's good to know though, because I can kind of get a sense of what kind of sizing I'll need. That's way too small. But I don't have a ton of room to play with either, which is kind of the thing. Yeah, that works for me. Have it fit inside that box. This does allow me to do vertical and horizontal thing, doesn't it? I need to go to my text tool. Interesting. No outline data. Is there not a way to... No, it's not that. I swear, there used to be a way, or there should have been a way, to make it so it's centered inside that bubble. I suppose I shouldn't spend too much time on it, because I'm not going to be using text directly from here anyway. I'm going to do it in OBS so that I can change it very easily each episode. But yeah. That's the gist of it. That's fine. I like that. It'd be centered, so we'll center it. Cool. I'm hoping that's big enough. I would say it is. We'll know when I export it. I'm actually going to make, that's problematic. Because I want to make the background of this black as well. But my issue with that is that you kind of need like multiple overlay layers then. But, I mean, that's not particularly difficult to do. It's just something I would need to do. So maybe that is something I should do. So what did we calculate that out as? 1040, I believe. Sorry, width 1040. Height was 550. Black stroke, black thing, Y 102, X. Oh no, that always messes it up because it's supposed to be this 100 by 3740. Right? Is that not right? That should be right. Why is that not correct? Not have a black stroke around it. Yeah, 10 pixels. Outside edge. So, 2700, 100. So what's this one? Where are you? Book cover. 2690 by 110. Oh, okay. Oh, actually, you know what? That's fine, because what we're going to do is on the background, this background gray I got, okay. Cover overlay. I want it that color. Yeah, okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this rectangle here and we're gonna merge them together. So what that means is that this is gonna stay a black square no matter what I'm doing. Which means that this does not need to be black either. Yeah, that perfect. So that in our overlay, when we go into it, we can just, the reason I'm doing it like this is because I want it so I can put, I want it so that there's a black edging around this box no matter what's in the background. And I didn't want to have to like overlay a bunch of images like in sequence to make that happen. So what I've done here is I've put that directly into the background. Our background is this, that gray with the gray. It's kind of hard to see, but because I matched it to this dark gray, but I really like that dark gray. So I kind of just went with it. But what we'll do is we'll quick export this and I can show you kind of more what I'm talking about. Yeah, so we don't want this or this. Yeah, so I'll show you what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna go to my test screen here. Oh, see, it just updated. So I'm also gonna add an image and call it book cover. Browse. Downloads, this one. So yeah, that's fine. So what you'll see then is that is now part of the background, so that when I put, sorry, wrong one. I want to hide that. So when I like, book cover. So I can move this and have it match up with stuff, and that's fine. Have it nicely inside our box here. And when I put this over, this will be underneath. See how then I can now resize this. Inside here. It's gonna have that black background independent of this dark gray. I will be more, I'm going to resize this, scale this more precisely in general, because I prefer that. So I'm gonna do 500. And then yeah, X and Y is, I should figure out what the X and the Y would be, right? Because it would be 550. So it's going to be 100, 110, 125. Yeah, 125. No, 135. That's what it'll be. Yeah, 135 will be perfect. Bounty box size would be 550 by 375, I think. Is that what we're gonna do with my bounty box? Yeah, I think so. So that'll be 110 and 690. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I want to do. So now I've set it up so that my image always scales. I know you guys can't see this, but I've set it up so my image always scales to the inside of the box. No matter what. So it'll look like that. Where's my preview here? Yeah. So it's always centered inside that box. No matter what I do. And then, just in the interest of showing off what this is probably going to look like, we're going to add some text. Boom. Select font. We want Fixis normal. What size did I say was good? 50. That's what I said was good, right? 50. Okay. The colors are weird though. That's odd. I'm just adding some text here just to show it off. Where's our color? Oh, okay, here we go. Now we can select color. So we want our 00FF00. Boom. Want the background color? No, we don't want a background color. We want the background to be non-existent. Alignment left, vertical alignment center. Boom. Weird. Try and scale this and make it so that it works. Scale to width of bounds. Want our bounds to be 655 to 550. Now, where are you? center to screen. Yeah, for some reason, outside of Photoshop, that font is not showing up for me, which is weird. I wonder if that's because it's a system font. It allows me to select it, but there's nothing in the preview window. I can show you what it looks like. It looks like this, and I don't know why. Because I don't know if it's just... No, Yeah, well, maybe I should use a different font. Yeah. I don't know why it's upside down either. I'm gonna fix that too. Scale the width of bounds, blah blah blah. 655, 550. We want it to be 3740. Do we not? 3740? No. Yeah. No, 3735, I think, was what we decided. I'm doing this. This is what I'm doing. Oh, I keep throwing up things onto the side here to show you guys, and I realize that you can't see it at all because there's no screen thing. My mistake. Give me a few seconds, I'll have this corrected. Yeah, for some reason, this one is going from, oh, positional alignment. Top left, right? Top left. Center. What the? How? Why is it doing that? Makes no sense. Sorry, I'm gonna have to recreate this. It's being weird. What I will do though is I will throw up a quick display capture here and just toss it down here. Oh, actually, this will be perfect because you know what I can show you now. Yeah, what I'll do is I'll go ahead right now and I'll really quick, I'll cut out these, I'll cut out that. It's a quick export. Save, yes. It uploads. Okay. Oh, whoops. That's why. Yeah, I made a mistake. Okay. There we go. Cool. So now I'm going to say that this properties. Okay. I'll say transform. Edit transform. I want this to be. This is probably gonna mess some things up, and I'll fool around with it after. But 1600 by 900. And I want this to be 110. I want this to be. Main house properties. I want this to be 600. actually gonna make this 1920 by 1080 again. Yeah, so then I just need to turn off this one option after. Perfect. If it messes up. Cool. So now let's fix this text. So you can see what I'm talking about. So yeah, when I go into the system font, see how it, like, nothing shows up here? But if you go to like this or this, that means it's like a system font and it's not showing up. That 8541 OEM one doesn't show up either, which is interesting. Let's go terminal. That doesn't show up either. Oh yeah, I forgot that I can set up a read for file. That would be perfect because then I'll just... Yeah, let's do that. Let's set that up real quick. So we're gonna go Twitch. I'm gonna have to reorganize some stuff tonight, I think. Files. New. Text document, book description. Cool. So Twitch files, book description. Typing away in this. I realize you guys probably can't see that much, but it's just to give you an idea of what's going on while I'm talking. So the cool thing about that is that means that I don't have to personally update it every single time. I can just change the text of that file and automatically update, which is sweet. Oh, terminal did show up. Interesting. So yeah, now we're gonna go transform, edit transform. We are going to go size. Is that what size we're gonna go? No, we're gonna go 600 by 550, I think. 600 by 550, yeah? No, maybe. Toss that background there so it's at least easy to look at. What did I want? This one. 655. Scale to inner bounds. 655 by 550. Position. Five by 110. Okay, cool. It worked this time. I think I scaled it too much, though. I think I should scale it to a smaller bounding box that's more positioned within it. For example, so what if I do scale to height? Is that just the same thing? Scale to width, same thing. Scale to outer. Scale to inner. No bounds. Stretch to bounds. No, maybe.
I think it's also partially because I did the I don't need it to wrap or anything, which is interesting. Like I pre-wrapped it. Yeah. Okay, well let's try a couple things. Why not? We're here, we're doing things. I've been streaming for 4.5 hours, which is crazy. Thank you to people who are still around from the beginning. I have not streamed this long ever. I'm feeling fine, like whatever. It's like I'm cool as long as I have a project to work on, you know? Like that's kind of the thing. So that positional alignment's fine, I think. Yeah, so basically what I want to do is I want to say scale to inner bounds, and I want to set the bounds to be something not quite as large. That's 312 by 178. The interesting thing to note is I don't, well, you guys can't see it, unfortunately, but there's, yeah, it's weird. It's super weird. So let's try some things. Let's try some things. So if I say that, okay. So that's 200 by 65 by 200. Let's make it a little bigger. Let's say 300, see what happens. Is that fine? That seems fine. Maybe 250? Oop. 250? 250 is not bad. 250 is not bad. The only reason I'm being all weird about it is because when I make this number 550, it stretches the words out to touch both edges, and I don't like it. So I'm trying to come up with like a way to make it so that it shrinks properly within that. Like, I like having it be more centered. Like, I'm just going down the list in sizes here. 350. 350 is not bad. I wonder, too, if I could change it a little bit by making it... like, if I change this like this, what happens? Yeah, maybe I should just do it like that. If I do 550 here now. I think we should go 650 as well. Maybe 600. By 550, and then move this so that it scales to 3100. What about that? How do we like that? Does that work? I kind of like it. I kind of like it like that. Just waiting for my preview to update here.
So, but now what happens if I do this? Save that. See, it stretches again, right? I wonder though if I should have two different setups, like one for books that don't have one for books that don't have like series, and one for ones with series. You know what I mean? Yeah, I actually prefer the other one. I think the other one's way better. Switching it back. So yeah, now I just gotta play around with it a little bit more, see if I can get it to do what I want. Does changing the font size matter? Probably not. I don't think so. Sorry, moving my mic around a bit. I also wonder if I also wonder if maybe I'm pretty sure I can get it to glow as well. Like, whoa. Yeah, don't do that. Do not do that. Huh. That's interesting. That's super interesting. How did I? What does that even mean? I mean, it's way too small to be readable, so I'd have to mess around with it, but that's interesting. Why is it doing it like that? Let's try a thing, I guess. Interesting. Now I'm super curious as to why what that option changed. Maybe I should just go. I have a dark theme. Interesting. Studio mode. Testing. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, whatever. It doesn't matter. I'll have to go configure all this stuff after anyway, so that's fine. Right now, what I should do is I should just finish up what I'm doing with this stuff. So I need to make. What do I have left? I guess I'll use this. I have to do name boxes, so I should do that. And then I think that's it. I think just name boxes. And then if I want to do something with that extra space, if there's something that would help with that, that might be an option. But I don't know. I think it's okay. I don't hate it. So now, 1280 by 720. So what I need to do is I need to create some boxes. So 1280 divided by 2 is 640. I'm not sure how high I want them. How high do I want them? Probably 50 pixels minimum. Pixel white, perfect. No, it's definitely gonna have to be taller. That's 100 pixels, really? That doesn't make sense. Oh, it went down, that's why. I was like, why? Why would it do that? Okay, so this will be. If we do bottom right corner, 2690 is perfect. We want our Y to be. One hundred plus 730, so. 830? No, 2160 minus 830. Right? 2160 minus 830. Yeah, that makes sense. Because. Yeah. That works. I think that works. I'm gonna make this, I'm gonna do what I did for this, the same as I did for the background, where I'm going to make a square that fits inside that's a different color, so that it's distinct from the rest of it. And I'm probably also gonna resize this logo-ish, because I think it's a little. Because I want it to be a little smaller so that it fits with what I'm doing. Go back to our move here. So top right corner this time. So we want it to be 100, yes, by what did I just say it was? Oh my God, 1330. So 100? Yeah, 100. Yeah, okay, yeah, we're good. I'm gonna delete that because I don't need it anymore. So what are you? one. So your co-host to name and you your co-host one name. This order does not matter. Wait a second. Did I delete that square? Oh, I totally did too. To be honest, it doesn't really matter. Because we move our chat box. Or did I? No, I didn't. I didn't delete it. Weird. What did I delete then? I deleted something. What layer was that? Go back to that. Oh, that was text. Yeah, okay. Never mind. We're good. Let's go back. Yeah, I didn't need that text either. That's fine. I'm gonna put this all together. Book description, chat box. I'm gonna put this into a folder. Sidebar. Then I'm gonna put this into group. That's going to be co-host 2. Like that. This is not something that's strictly necessary. I'm just organizing the file so, you know, if I have to send it to anybody, if I need to use it for something else, it's easy to navigate. It's as easy as possible to navigate. Okay. Main host, border. Rename this. Logo. For the moment, because that's what it is. Okay. I'm going to group that. This is going to be called background. But I'm going to have to, can I? Oh, I can quick export just that layer. Interesting. Cool. That makes sense. That's really useful. That's really useful. Oh my God. All right. So yeah, I'm going to, right. So I got to do a name box for the main guy there. Why does that look different to me? If I go like this. I go like this. Are those on the same line? I'm not sure they're on the same line. No, they gotta be on the same line. There's no way. I'm just crazy. That's because I'm looking at it at an angle. That's why. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and cut out this as well now because I don't think it's necessary. I'm kind of wondering if I want this border to be this gray as well. crazy hard to see right now. But yeah, let's change that real quick actually. Can I do that? I can do that, right? Yeah, cool. Oh, you know what I should do is I should just get some I should just get some like command line sort of style looking stuff and toss it in the background. That's what I should do. Like just like merge, like make it like a flat merge. Man, I'm getting real fancy now. Real fancy. I like that though. I like the way this is turning out. Let's get the last. I mean, that image would be pretty cool, but I don't think I'm gonna do that right now. I need a break at some point. I am gonna do the last name for sure, because I need to do that. So I'm gonna do it. 640 by 100. This got weird options. All right, 10 and outer. Okay, cool. Yeah, I want it like that. Host name, group these together. Main host, cool. I'll toss this logo down on the bottom, actually. Something like that. That too close together? That might be too close together. Very well, could be too close together. Hundred 1070 by 1010 1010. This would be 100 plus 910. So 1010 is perfect. I'm fine with that. That's perfect. Yeah. I don't know if I should do anything with that. I'm gonna duplicate this real quick. And turn one off. And then I'm gonna resize it and see if that matters. What do you think? Small one, big one? I like the small one better, actually. So I'm gonna use the small one, I think. Yeah, I'm gonna use the small one. I'll leave both there just in case. I'm gonna group these. Where's my group? Can I not group them? Am I not allowed to group them? Okay, never mind, I got it. Small logo and big logo. We're gonna keep the small one active. Now I just need to make that background image. And the way that I'm gonna do that is actually a little different from what I was doing before. I'm gonna duplicate you, and you. Move you down here. Now these duplicates, I'm gonna go ahead and hide the rest of this, actually. So other than this stuff, so I'm just gonna mess around with the properties real quick, and just go. Do I want them to be black? Is black what I want? Let's try black. Black what I want. Hid them the wrong way. I need to turn off the folders, is what I need to turn them off. It's black what I want to do. Yeah, I think probably black is what I want to do. I do think though that the names should probably not be green. I think that's what I want. Whatever. Even if it's not, I can always go back and change it later. But I do just want to get this done. Yeah, that looks good. good. I'm pretty happy with that. Make them red or pink. Yeah, I can make them red. I'm actually not opposed to that. It would have to be a dull red. Like something like this. Oh, you mean the text? Yeah, because I don't think the text should be green. Yeah, red, green. Sorry. Red text could definitely be good. For example, I can do it real quick. Something like that. That might be okay. I don't know. I'll play around with that. That'll be something I do in OBS. I'll see what works. I might just leave it green. It depends. But I like the way this is turning out. So let's merge these. So now if I turn off this stuff, you have all your bars. Perfect. Yeah, that's a good point. If I'm not using this as a black border, I don't even need it. But that being said, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to leave it there because then if I do want to color it, I can just color it. That's fine. So yeah, I think I'm done. So yeah, whoa, yeah. Sorry, getting real tired now. Whew. How long have I been streaming? Jesus, 5 hours. Oh my god. Okay. So yeah, cool. Go back to this now. So yeah, that's not everything I wanted to do today, but it is a portion of what I wanted to do today. So that's good. I still got to do a channel description and all that, and I'll do that because I need to have that ready for tomorrow. So that's fine. That's all stuff I will do. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. Took a lot longer than I expected it to be honest. But I'm just kind of a weird perfectionist, so, you know, it takes time and effort and trying out things. I mean, I'm not a designer by any means. I do know some things about design. I know some things about certain things. I hang out with a lot of artists. It is what it is. So, yeah, this is going to be that's going to be the overlay for the Read-Write show for the first... at least probably the first 2 or 3 episodes we're thinking. But yeah, it'll be interesting. That show will be airing tomorrow night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time here on Accidental Origin at 2020. Here on Accidental Origin, it'll be me, my good friend Sam, MC Pepper Pockets himself is going to be the main host. We're going to be talking about this guy here, The Last Witch by Andre Sapkowski, the first book of the Witcher series. And yeah, it's going to be the start of that. That's going to be a bi-weekly show. So every 2 weeks, we're going to be doing an episode of that on Mondays. Yeah, I'm really excited. It's going to be fun. Is there anything else I wanted to talk about? Nope, that's pretty much it. So yeah, as always, you guys can check me out on accidentalorigin.com where you can see, down there. accidentalorder.com, where you can see all my previous episodes and stuff I've worked on. My website is always out of date. I need to get on that. I need to get back up to speed. And I will be doing that the next couple of days. But yeah, things need to happen with that for sure. What else? Oh, yeah. Yeah. So all of these overlays and all that will be available on there. I will have them up as part of the episode files and stuff like that, along with a Photoshop file. Because why not? People might enjoy it. Beats me. Yeah. I don't know. What else do I have to say about that? Nope, that's it. All my contact information is there. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, suggestions, please don't hesitate to contact me. What else? Nope, that's about it. Be sure to follow. And 1 a.m. It happens. It happens. So yeah, that's it. That's it for me, guys. I'm fading fast. Without further ado, my name is Brendan. This is Accidental Origin, a weekly writing web show. We didn't really do any writing today, but it was all kind of related. So, you know, whatevs. It is what it is. Take care. Have a good one, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. I really appreciate it. Yeah.